It's Tuesday, April 15th, 2008. I'm James Kotecki. Welcome to the show and happy tax day. Kentucky Congressman Jeff Davis has apologized to Barack Obama after telling the crowd at a Republican dinner that Obama is like a snake oil salesman. In other words, a sham, a mellifluous phony, a flimflam man. But that criticism isn't so harsh. Oh, and in reference to Obama's potential control of America's nuclear arsenal as president, Davis quipped that that boy's finger does not need to be on the button. But it's okay, though, because Davis did apologize to Obama, stating that his comment in no way reflects the personal and professional respect he has for Obama. Oh, okay, so he totally respects Obama, he just thinks he's an incompetent phony. Does the word respect mean anything in politics? And by the way, how did Davis come to his conclusions about Obama's abilities? According to the original story on the blog Poll Watcher, he had participated with Obama in a highly classified national security simulation. Well, Congressman Davis, I guess you wouldn't be able to tell us any details of Obama's performance because that would be highly classified, but it does seem like there may have been some tension during the exercise. But please, gentlemen, you can't fight in there. It's a war room. Next, a government witness has testified at the trial of Chicago real estate developer Tony Resco that he recalls seeing Barack Obama at a party that Resco threw to court a controversial Iraqi-born investor. As the New York Times reported, an Obama spokesman says he does not remember attending such an event. Resco helped raise at least $250,000 for Obama's previous campaigns, but Obama has denied helping Resco and has so far managed to shake off such allegations. But let's not overlook the real story here. Tony Resco is living a real-life version of Arrested Development. Think about it, the real estate developing, the alleged corruption, the links to Iraq. So it's probably wise for Obama to back as far away from this as possible. After all, if he ever gets in trouble, he just has to remember that there's always money in the banana stand. Finally, Bill Clinton stated at 7 campaign stops in North Carolina that everywhere he goes, he sees signs that says, I'm not bitter. Thing is, as ABC reports, there were no signs like that at any of those 7 campaign stops. That kind of makes sense because it seems to me that the people most likely to make a sign saying they're not bitter would be the ones who are bitter about being called bitter. So of course that sets up a whole logical paradox situation that could probably rip the fabric of the space-time continuum, etc., etc. Well, that's it for today. So check out politico.com/nothing. And don't worry about logical paradoxes because this statement is false. Right here on Kotecki TV.